We know that because of the pandemic and countless other factors, that not only the MCU's Phase 4 slate has been shifted, but that projects have been in some cases drastically changed. I mean, originally it was supposed to be WandaVision, then Doctor Strange in the Multiverse of Madness, and finally Spider-Man No Way Home. But obviously that's changed, and Doctor Strange 2 is coming out later this year. We also know that originally Spider-Man 3 was going to be a movie focused on Kraven the Hunter, and the aftermath of Peter being revealed to be Spider-Man, but that was later pushed to a backup plan following the most recent deal with Sony. And instead they decided to bring Toby, Andrew, and their respective villains back. But it's now been revealed by No Way Home's writers that originally Venom was supposed to appear in the final battle instead of just having a short cameo in the post-credit scene. Next, following the success of Spider-Man PS4 and Miles Morales, fans are eagerly awaiting Spider-Man 2. And while I don't talk about this game too much, I do try to cover the most important news. In the trailer, it was revealed that Venom will play a large role in the story, which was of course set up in the previous two games, and so it was only a matter of time before we got to wear the black suit in the game. Recently though, it was rumored that there was a chance that every single suit in the game had a symbiote counterpart. For example, the advanced suit that Peter wore throughout most of the game would turn into the black suit, but there'd also be an Iron Spider symbiote suit or a Spider-Man 2099 symbiote suit, etc. And now fans have found the symbiote suit in Spider-Man PS4. Now this could of course be explained as a glitch, but it could also be that maybe the developers were testing out what the suit would look like on the Spider-Man PS4 model, seeing as that game's already finished, and most of the assets will probably get reused in the new game. They might be updated slightly, but I doubt they'll remake them all. So this way, they can at least get an idea as to what it'll look like in the second game. And maybe someone made a mistake, or it was just an accident, but for some reason, some people were able to see at least half of the suit in the game. And lastly, it's already been revealed that Shang-Chi will get a sequel. And in a recent interview with Complex, Simu Liu stated, "I think that Sean has to decide what to do with all his newfound power. It kind of consumed his father, consumed Wenwu. So I'm curious as to how someone much younger, much more inexperienced, would fare against the rings. Just this idea of all of a sudden being gifted something that's so powerful, but also so dangerous. And then the other big question I have is, in what way does Sean fit in with the rest of the MCU? Who are we gonna see? What kind of crazy team-ups and what kind of tie-ins or Easter eggs? I'm just as in the dark as everyone else, so I don't know anything, but I'm excited to dive into that process." And honestly, this is a really easy question to answer. The only right answer is Iron Fist. Sure, it'd be interesting to see Shang-Chi with Ant-Man or Spider-Man, but Iron Fist and the Defenders are the most obvious choice, and the title for the second movie just makes sense. Shang-Chi and the Legend of the Iron Fist. Literally couldn't be more simple. But let me know what you guys think about all this. Do you think Venom should have been included in No Way Home's final battle? What do you think of the symbiote suit in Spider-Man PS4? And what other characters do you think we'll see in Shang-Chi 2? If you enjoyed the video, don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and turn on post notifications so you will never miss another video. Thanks for watching, and remember to wash your hands and stay safe.